Hi, this is your girl Wilma, the studying the Holy Bible today, and I hope our Bible study leads you closer to a walk with God. And I hope you turn to your Bibles to Romans chapter 4, verse 18 through 25. Okay, 18 through 25. Okay, and it says, "Who against hope believed it in hope, that he might become the father of many nations, according to that which was spoken, so shall thy seed be." Now we're talking about Abraham here. Verse 19. "And being not weak in faith, he considered it not his own body, now dead, when he was about 100 years old, neither yet the deadness of Sarah's womb. He staggered not at the promise of God through unbelief, but was strong in faith, giving glory to God, and being fully persuaded that what he had promised it, he was able also to perform. And therefore it was imputed to him for righteousness. Now it was not written for his sake alone that it was imputed to him, but for us also, so to whom it shall be imputed, if we believe on him that raised up Jesus our Lord from the dead, who was delivered it for our offenses and was raised again for our justifications." Yes, for our justifications. Okay, now we go to our notes. See, Abraham got a promise from God, and instead of allowing the waiting period for it to come to pass weaken his faith, it says that he was strengthened in his faith and gave glory to God, being fully persuaded that God has power to do what he promised it. It says, from the time God gave him the promise till it was fulfilled, I think it was at least 25 years. That's what some pastors have been saying. It took that long. That's a long time to wait. But he knew who his father was, and he did not allow time and waiting to discourage him, for allowing him to doubt. I believe he was strengthened in faith because he knew as each day passed it, he was one day closer to that promise being fulfilled. How many times do we pray, accept, and hear from God about a promise, but then we allow the waiting, other people getting in our heads? You sure can't believe God is going to help you in this. Let's get us down. Don't let people's words do that to you. Sorry about the ringing on my phone. Okay. And don't let nothing, other people doubts, and try to put more doubt into your heart, into your head, trying to get you down. Keep that promise and that word in your head, what God can do and all his promises. Okay? We go from being strong in faith and knowing our God, but then time gets away and begin to doubt. We begin to allow Satan's words of defeat become more real than God's promises. We shouldn't allow that. You know, just because it's not happening on our own time or how we think it's supposed to happen. 25 years Abraham waited, yet we give up after a few days if we see no change in our circumstances. And I believe the Lord is saying to let this be an encouragement to you that it doesn't matter how long it takes to stop looking at your circumstances or listening to other people. Because when you do that, when doubt when that would come, you begin to think him, maybe that's right. Maybe this is too far gone. But if you stay in his word and allow his word to be more real and more bigger and greater than what you're facing, then his promise will be fulfilling in his timing. Now say this little prayer with me, okay? Father, I will stand on your promises no matter how long it takes. It's all in your timing. I just need to stand and hold my peace in Jesus' name. And I hope our Bible study is leading you closer to God and closer walk with God, I'm hoping. Now, you remember to come back and see me next time on our next videos.